All right, I know we got a lot of things to cover. I know there's a lot of news, but let's keep this a buck, all right? Yo, Will Smith just smacked the bullshit out of fucking Chris Rock at the Oscars and then sat there and simped out like a little girl, was like, keep my wife's name out your mouth, my wife. Yo, here, watch this shit.
Jada, I love you. G.I. Jane 2, can't wait to see it. All right? That was a nice one. Okay. I'm out here. Uh-oh. Richard. Oh, wow. Will Smith just smacked the shit out of me. Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane joke.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
I'm going to, okay? Okay. That was a greatest night in the history of television. Okay. Okay.
Okay, for all of y'all that don't know what's going on, right? Like, all right, let me explain some things about Will Smith here that a lot of y'all might not know. All right, first off, his wife, Jada Pinkett Smith, all right, she is in love with a dead man, namely a dude named Tupac Shakur.
Relationship with Pac and trying to figure that out, you know, and that was a huge loss in my life.
Absolutely, yeah.
Because he was one of those people that I expected to be here. And my upset is more anger. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Because I feel that he left me. And I know that's not true. And it's right. A very selfish way to think about it, but I really did believe that he was gonna be here for the long run.
All right. And, you know, I mean, Will Smith basically hawked her down. And then here recently, like a year and a half ago, she ended up getting into a relationship with a dude named August Alsina. And she went on a red carpet and this red table talk thing, right, with Will Smith, and like broke this down to the point where like she literally said, like, the girth and the thickness of his love was so amazing, right?
Much different manner. I would,
during that time, launched into an interaction with August. What do you feel like you were looking for?
I just wanted to feel good. Mm-hmm. It had been so long since I felt good.
Yeah. Husband, I gotta be with you at the press conference. While you like tell the world about your transgressions. Well, like, I love my baby. I'm gonna stand by my baby no matter what.
No, I definitely understand why it would look that way or feel that way, but I actually don't look at it as a transgression at all. Through that particular journey, I learned so much about myself and was able to really confront a lot of emotional immaturity, emotional insecurity, and I was really able to do some really deep healing.
You know what I'm saying? And like, Will had to sit through all this nonsense. And let's keep this 100. Will Smith was laughing at, like, when he made that joke, right? Because, you know, it was kind of funny, whatever. And she's the one who got upset. And she got all Karen'd out and got that fucking look on her motherfucking face. And when she did so, literally, motherfucking Will Smith had to get up and go handle his goddamn business. Yo, look, Will Smith didn't need to do shit. All right, that is a simp-ass motherfucking move. Like, 100%. I don't give a fuck how gangster you think you are. You are no longer going to be welcome in a lot of places you act this fucking way. Now, look, I'm a savage. All right, legit. Now, I keep it a savage. But in keeping it a savage, I realize there's places that I just don't belong. Namely, where you're going to find individuals who have a lot of money. And unfortunately, Will Smith's entire career is based off of being around individuals who have a lot of money. Yo, look, let's watch this one more time and we'll break it down piece by piece.
Jada, I love you. G.I. Jane 2, can't wait to see it. All right?
It's just... Now, I know there's going to be people out there that go, she got alopecia. Like, that just means she got female balding. All right? Legit. It's not a real fucking, like, she got cancer or some shit. She just got male pattern baldness, right? Legit. Same fucking thing. No fucking difference. All right? And, like, yo, it's a cheap joke, but, like, it's a safe joke for the most part. Like, no one else on the planet would get that butthurt about that fucking shit.
That was a nice one. Okay. I'm out here. Uh-oh. Richard.
Watch closely. You're about to experience a nigga moment.
Slap.
Now, look, I know that, you know what I'm saying? Like, sometimes it is necessary to slap a hoe. But I'll be real, you don't slap a man. To be a fact, man, Charlie Murphy literally broke this down right after this. He said it better than I did.
First of all, you don't slap a man. Okay? I mean, even when slapping was fashionable, they did it in Paris, the guy would come up, my bad, I challenge you to a duel. They would have a gunfight after that. Somebody had to go.
Oh, wow. Wow. Will Smith just smacked the shit out of me.
Now, for all y'all youngsters, I want y'all to see this is what's known as having class, right? Literally, like, somebody did something off the wall, and he's like, you know what? I'm not going to retaliate. I'm going to be a grown-ass man. I'm going to try and handle my business. I'm getting paid to do this tonight. And, like, yo, this paycheck's important because I got bills to pay. And Will Smith apparently did not feel that way because he decided, oh, you know what, man? I'm not going to let you derail this motherfucking moment. I'm just going to continue on.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
Wow, dude.
Yes.
It was a G.I. Jane jump.
Keep my wife's name out your fucking mouth.
Well, that was awkward.
Yes, it was.
Sort of a private conversation.
Very much a family type moment.
We didn't need to hear any of that.
Mm-hmm. Not for our ears.
I mean, all right, let's keep this 100% here, all right? Legitimately, I don't know really what to say about that, right? I mean, because, like, even for me, like, hearing them, watching them scream like that, it's just like, yo, like, I know that legitimately, like, he really felt that way at that moment. And I don't know why any human being would feel that way about that broad. Right, especially after she made that I just caught the stomach bug virus face. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, it just, that was completely and utterly unnecessary. Like, just fully, right? And I know there's going to be a lot of dudes going like, oh, he's talking about his wife, right? And I just don't care, right, as a whole. I don't get, like, you're a public person. Like, and sometimes you're just going to catch a little heat. It's nothing extremely serious, and you know it wasn't nothing serious. This is Chris Rock making a bullshit joke, and literally, like, you thought it rose to the level of violence, and then sitting there threatening an individual after that. And I'm gonna say threatening because, like, it's keep my wife's name out your mouth or else is the end of that statement, right? Legitimately. Right? Because, like, that's not a full statement unless you put a preposition at the end of that. Like, 100%. Like, yo, you literally sat here and put it on that level where you've, like, Chris Rock has to, like, worry about what you're gonna do if he continues to use his words at a public forum at a place he's paid to be funny. This is just, in general, tragic. As a whole, like, to watch Will Smith act this way.
I'm going to, okay? Okay.
Why'd you do that?
What did you see?
You literally dumbfounded Chris Rock. He's standing here. I have no idea what the fuck to say. That's literally where the fuck he's at. Like, that's fucking crazy.
That was a greatest night in the history of television. Okay.
I don't know about the greatest night in the history of television, but I'll tell you what, Will Smith might be the greatest simp in the history of Hollywood. 100%. walk on stage like John Wayne, slap another fucking comedian, and then sit back in the crowd and scream like a fucking child. Jesus Christ. Fucking bananas. Anyway, yo, looks, Tom Pease with P-Noid News. You know how it works. Like, share, and subscribe. Peace.